Evaluating sex differences for patients undergoing surgery is vital to improve the care of these patients and their experience and ensure that care is equitably delivered for both men and women. Our earlier work evaluated the effect of surgeons' sex on adult surgical patients and showed that patients who are treated by female surgeons have better outcomes than those who are treated by male surgeons. One of the proposed explanations for this difference we saw was the relationship between the sex of the patient and the sex of their treating surgeon. Sex discordance is when a patient and a physician are of a different sex. For example, the patient is female and the physician is male. It appears that when patients and females are not of the same sex, patients experience worse outcomes. And this is particularly true for female patients who are treated by male doctors. Hence, the objective of our study here is to explore whether discordance between patients and surgeon sex affects outcomes after common surgeries.
This study focused on adult Ontarians having one of 21 common and complex elective and emergency surgeries over a 13-year period. The patients were identified using administrative population-level healthcare data from ICES. The main outcome studied was a combination of adverse outcomes after surgery that included 30-day mortality, readmission, and complications after surgery, outcomes that are important to both patients and our health system leaders. Our additional secondary analysis studied each of these components separately, as well as length of stay. The main analysis looked at the association of four options of patient and surgeon sex with our combined adverse outcome after adjusting for the many other important factors that can affect how well patients do after surgery. For example, patient age, chronic health issues, type of hospital, procedural volume for individual surgeons, surgeon experience, etc.
Our study included over 1.3 million patients who were treated by approximately 3,000 surgeons. Female surgeons represented about one quarter of all surgeons, and just over 50% of patients underwent surgery with a practitioner of a different sex. Overall, approximately 15% of patients experienced an adverse outcome after surgery, although these rates varied between 5% in plastic surgery and 26% in cardiac surgery.
After adjusting for patient comorbidities, surgeon sex, and volume, we found that there was an association between surgeon and patient sex discordance and worse outcomes. However, this was not consistent for male and female patients. Male patients had similar outcomes irrespective of whether their surgeon was male or female. There was a small reduction in the odds of death among male patients operated on by female surgeons compared to male surgeons, but similar risk of readmission and complications. For female patients, the odds of having an adverse outcome was 15% higher when the surgeon was male compared to a female surgeon. There was an increase in odds of death by 32%, complications by 16%, readmission by 11%, and length of stay by 20%.
There are some limitations to this study. We couldn't separately analyze gender rather than sex as a sociocultural variable, given that we have no database that collects this information. As well, some surgeries may be technically more challenging than others, which could affect the results. However, with our large patient sample size, thousands of surgeons that are largely trained in similar programs, and categorization by the type of surgery, there was no indication that at a systematic level, we were seeing differences in the kinds of surgeries between surgeons of different sexes.
The findings warrant further research to really understand why surgeons who are given similar training will have different outcomes for patients of a different sex. This might be related to non-technical skills like communication styles, decision-making, and team management. Gender bias also plays a role here, and studies need to explore this further. We need to encourage our patients to develop good communication with their doctor and remind that healthcare providers learn new and better or different ways of delivering care to patients of any social or economic background. Finally, underrepresentation of female physicians in medicine calls for policies to help support and retain women entering surgery, which could aid patient safety and future positive growth in medicine.